an immediate stop on all construction projects of which were not approved by the right authorities. The team says the operation is aimed at protecting innocent lives that have been lost each time such buildings collapse. Engineer Flavia Gutobwire, who led the team from National Building Review Board, closed down buildings in Ntinda and Makindye.
We start the enforcement of the Building Control Act in line with the information that has come to our disposal. This particular site was submitted, the drawings for this site were submitted for approval. KCCA deferred them, asking for additional information. The developer ignored that, went ahead and did the construction. As he does the construction, during the monitoring phase, KCCA discovers the construction is taking place. It is illegal and asks for a structural assessment of what is on site. The structural assessment is done and it indicates that the building is not structurally sound.
So they proceeded to Salama Road, where they discovered a petrol station that was illegally being constructed. Those found on site were apprehended and taken to Katwe Police. The move is mainly to restore sanity in the city through proper physical planning.
Division 8 Eza Kampala. Mulimu ebizimbe ebyebizimbibwa n'ebyo ebyazimbibwa edda ebisoba mu 1500 ebitatuukana na mutindo. Era ekikwekwero kino ekitandise kigenda kufuuza ebizimbe ebyo byonna bannannyini baabyo bavunaanibwe n'ebizimbe ebyo byennyini biyimirizibwe okutuusa nga bigoberedde amateeka.
This very site we are on, we had approved commercial structures, but the developer has changed into a petrol station, which a fuel station which has never been approved. And even then, the National Physical Planning Board had already given a directive that we shouldn't approve these petrol stations. It is going to be demolished. One, it is not approved by the authority. Okay?
Story was compiled by Ronald Kasasa for the news in Kampala.
Teachers, health workers and police officers who were deployed to serve islands in Jinja City want government to remit their risk allowances and also provide them with fiber boats and accommodation for effective service delivery. Our reporter has more.
Last year, 2020, we were not given our allowances. We don't know how our administrators are working about that issue. You find that those administrators, it is a big challenge.
Jinja City has three islands, namely Kisima 1, Kisima 2, and Rabitoke. The islands are densely populated, therefore a need for extension of